The goal for every person with diabetes is to match their insulin doses and their carbs eaten to achieve balanced blood glucose levels. But how do we know what a good balance is? After all, blood glucose never stays at one level for very long. Blood glucose can be affected by many things, including the amount and type of carbs eaten, the amount of insulin that is given, the child's activity levels, and stress. No two people with T1D are the same. Each person with T1D may react differently, even if they have the exact same diet and insulin doses. Because blood glucose can vary so much, it's important to monitor it throughout the day in order to be safe. We'll talk more about different ways to monitor blood glucose in another module later on. Because blood glucose levels can change so much, we use a range of numbers that are healthy. This is called the target blood glucose range. You can think of the target blood glucose range like a dartboard. You aim for the target in the middle, but it's okay if you're a little off. The more time spent in the target range, the better. Going above this range can lead to health issues like ketones and ketoacidosis, while going below this range can lead to unconsciousness, seizures, or even death. In general, when we refer to blood glucose levels, we use a number and a label of milligrams per deciliter, which is the standard unit of measure in the United States. This measures the number of milligrams of glucose in a deciliter of blood. Other countries may use different measures, like millimole per liter or millimolar. In this video series, whenever we mention a blood glucose level, we're using the milligrams per deciliter measurement. When we talk about the target blood glucose range, we're aiming for the space between 70 and 180. Results less than 70 are considered low. We'll talk more about low blood glucose, known as hypoglycemia, in the next video. Likewise, results above 180 are considered high. High blood glucose is referred to as hyperglycemia. We'll also talk about hyperglycemia more in a future video. In an ideal diabetes care routine, we want at least 50 to 60% of blood glucose results within the target range, which means the child's blood glucose should be between 70 and 180 around half the time. We understand that highs and lows will happen to everyone, and that's understandable. The key to healthy diabetes management is minimizing the number of out-of-range values by developing healthy habits and having the knowledge to correct out-of-range blood glucose values when they happen. The target blood glucose range changes a bit throughout the day to guarantee safety and ensure healthy outcomes. For example, before meals, a child's blood glucose should ideally be somewhere between 90 to 130. It is possible for the blood glucose to be below the target range and not have a low blood glucose. Remember, a low blood glucose is any result less than 70. 2 hours after meals, the blood glucose should ideally be less than 180. It's important to wait a short time before checking blood glucose after eating, so both the insulin and carbs from the meal have time to be absorbed. Overnight, we aim for the blood sugar to be somewhere between 90 to 150. We recommend reaching at least 90 to 100 before going to sleep to avoid the possibility of dropping low overnight. The diabetes team will help you determine a fixed blood glucose number called a correction target, like 120, unique to each child that you can use whenever you need to give a correction dose of insulin to treat a high blood glucose. The name is a little tricky. The correction target isn't meant to be a goal. It's only used for insulin math. It's impossible to keep the blood glucose at this exact level all the time, which is understandable considering how many things can affect blood glucose. The correction target for calculations is a little different for every person with diabetes, and it may change over time. We'll show you how to use the correction target later in this series. While it's important to monitor blood sugar throughout the day, more blood glucose checking is not always better. Sometimes families feel anxious when they don't know their blood glucose, and this leads to overchecking, which can cause stress and interrupt daily activities the child enjoys. Keep in mind, we recommend checking blood glucose between 4 to 6 times per day. Insulin takes time to work and food takes time to be broken down, so blood glucoses are always changing and checking too often might just be confusing.
T1D tip, pardon the interruption, my name is Rosalie. I'll be popping in from time to time to give some suggestions about how to take care of T1D emotionally as well as medically. When we talk about all the numbers involved in T1D, it can be helpful to remove labels like good or bad from blood glucose numbers to improve lifelong diabetes well-being. Instead, think of the number as information that tells us what to do to keep us safe, like the information you get from the colors in a stoplight. Red lights and green lights aren't good or bad. They tell us how to respond to stay safe on the road. That's all for now.
Thank you, Rosalie. In the next few videos, we'll talk more about hypoglycemia and hyperglycemia and how to treat them.